G'day, my name's Justin, I'm from Black Opal Direct. Today I want to talk to you about cutting pairs. So if you want to make a nice set for an earring, the best way to start is, once we have our stones rubbed out to an approximate size, we can match them all up together. So you get all the stones together that you've got from the same lot, because usually you'll find a pair in the same area or the same lot of opal that you've got. And so what we do is, the first thing, we match up color. So you put the stones together and you sort them out into their little patches of the right color, okay? So, and we go through it really meticulously, because if you have an opal pair that is cut to the right size on each stone, but they just don't look right, they don't look right on your ears either. So we must look at the colors, and we sort out the pieces that match into the right colors. Then we go into the patterns and we sort out the stones that have very similar patterns as well. Now, it doesn't happen very often that you get a pair, so that's why they're so rare, is we need to match up two stones that have the same color, the same body tone, the same pattern, or very similar pattern, and there we have our pair. Now, to get this pair to be perfect, we must get a set of calipers. For when we start cutting on the opal cutting machine, we got to make sure that this pair have the same dimensions. So by trimming the smallest one first to an oval, you get the oval shape, and then you measure that. And once you've measured that, you can start to cut the bigger stone down to the size of the smaller stone. But always start with the smaller stone first, because you can cut the bigger stone and the oval's there, but then you've got to cut it down anyway to the size of the other stone. Sometimes I've found a long stone and a short stone together that make a beautiful pair, because the color and the pattern and the body tone is very similar. Now, sometimes it's worth for you to cut that long stone right down to the size of the smaller stone, because pairs are worth a lot more money than just a single stone, because they're so rare. So there you have it. I've shown you a few little tips about how to make an opal pair. There are a few things about the jewellery pieces that you need to, if you've already got the jewellery without the stones in it, you have to make sure you cut them both to exactly the same size, so that when you close the claws or you close the rubbed over setting, that they both fit nicely. Because when they're sitting on your ears and one looks a little bit out and the other one's perfect, it doesn't look quite right. So you gotta be really precise. So I hope you've helped you out again, and see you next time. Thank you.